Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of our Farming RPG tutorial series. So now to pick up where we left off, as you can see when you enter, our chickens are all facing the same direction. Sometimes you don't see them because they're stuck in funny places. So in this part, we are going to fix that. So first off, let's go over to our animal spawn manager. And we want to change this. Instead of quaternion.identity, we want to generate a random angle the animal will face. First, let's randomize the Y rotation because that's the only axis we want it to rotate around. We don't want any funny rotations. So in this case, our X and Z have a rotation of 0, while our Y would be a random value. Then we replace this with random rotation. And now when I enter, you can see that they're all facing different angles. And that leaves us to fix our next problem. Things like these, where they spawn in very weird places, where they're not supposed to. To do that, let's create a nav mesh. So in our chicken coop scene, go to navigation, go to bake, and here we have our little nav mesh. So this will determine where our chickens can walk. And now we go over to the chicken prefab itself and attach a nav mesh agent. And we should adjust it to its size. So you can see its radius is 0.305. So let's adjust our nav mesh accordingly. So it can wander around these parts. Save this. And with that, we can start on the movement. So let's create a new script for this animal movement. And we're using UnityEngine.ai. It's going to be from the component itself. Prevent feature errors. We can require component. So in that case, every time we attach this component in the editor, it will always ensure that there is a nav mesh agent attached to it. And with that, let's make a new function called wander and call this an update. Now we want it to walk around to a random point on the map within the scene. So first we need to generate something in a random direction. For now we're just gonna put 10 because it's easier that way. If you want, you can make a variable here and then have it adjusted, but I don't think it's necessary. It's within the same area, doesn't really matter that much. And then we need to offset this with the actual transform position. We can do that with a simple addition. And then we'll need to check whether it's a valid point. Because for all you know, the destination could be off the map. With a nav mesh agent, the animal will not be able to move too. So we'll have to sample its position. And it should output the nearest position within the nav mesh that we can go to. So we'll need to declare nav mesh hit. And then we'll put 10. areas would be all areas. And then from that, we can get the position by vector 3 from the hit. And then we move towards there. Since we're putting this in update, it will call it every frame. So we need to check whether it's in the middle of moving. To do that, we'll have to check whether it's calculating anything. It's in the middle of computing its path. So it has to make sure it's not computing its path. That means there's no destination set. And the remaining distance is less than 0.5. That means it's either reaching or has already reached its previous destination. And now let's attach this to our chicken. Now when you enter, you see the chickens are constantly moving around randomly. But it's not healthy for them to keep moving around like that. I think you want them to walk around a bit and stop every once in a while. So, let's add a cooldown. This is our cooldown timer. So if our cooldown timer is underway, the timer will run minus time the delta time, so it decreases by the elapsed time. And then every time we set a new destination, we reset the cooldown timer. And let's give our chickens cooldown time of 8 seconds. And as you can see, they move and then they stop. And then after a while, they start moving again. But they are too synchronized, which is not natural. It doesn't look like they are animals at all, but robots. You see, they all move at the same time, which is not what we want. So at the start, we can randomize the cooldown timer. Now they should be able to... Yep, and now they move at different times because of the delay. Another thing is when you talk to them, they ignore you and they just continue business as usual, as you can see. Which is not what we want. We want them to stop moving when you talk to them. So let's add a function called toggle movement. And this just toggles the navmesh agent. So when it's disabled, it'll stop moving. And over in animal behavior, make a reference to the animal movement component. Going to require it again, and we're going to get component. And now when we interact with it, let's disable the movement. And once the dialogue finishes, we can continue. So, stop moving as long as I'm talking to it. It's not move. Once I stop, it continues. And yep, that's it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you next time. That's it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed the video. Want to support what we do? You can help us by becoming a patron. This will give you access to the project files for our tutorials, as well as patron-exclusive posts on our blog. Any support you can give will go a long way. Currently, we are making back about 20 cents for every dollar that we put into content creation. So your help will go a long way to help make this a sustainable endeavor. And with that, we'll see you next time.